Hey guys, Magenta is back here today again with another awesome deck profile, my Royal Paladin Strike deck, featuring Strike. Yeah, okay. So basically, yeah, Strike is an all-new game mechanic which allows you to summon some past dead comrades to join you in the fray again. So we'll start with the main deck first. Yep, this is starter. So generation break one. So current plus one, put this unit into your soul and search your deck for a grid 2 unit and call it to rearguard circle and shuffle your deck. Pretty decent starter. So right now generation break is very strong. So vanguards, rearguards all have it. Yeah. Even starters, yes. Alright, so let's get on with the grid trees. So 4, Knight of Blue Heavens, Altomile. So basically this is the boss monster of this deck. So generation break 2, all units in your front row gets plus 5k power, and it's continued, so it's pretty good. Next, Cannon Blast 1, when G unit strikes on this, you can choose to cut from your hand and call it, and choose 2 rear guards plus 5k power to each of them. So it's pretty good. Even if you don't call, you still can give the power to your rear guards. Yep. That's the boss monster of the deck. Next. So one thing Bushiroad changed is grade 3 boss monsters. Yeah, pretty decent, still commons now. So this is like a crew dragon from Kagero. So basically counter blast 1, soul blast 1 and G break 1. When this unit attacks a vanguard, you can search your deck for a grade 2 unit and call it to a rear guard and shuffle your deck. So basically it's consistent calling. Yeah, but Altomile's 5k to front row is much better. And this other skill is when this unit is placed on vanguard, you may pay cost. If you do, soul blast 1, choose a card from your hand and call it, and choose 1 rear guard plus 5k. So it's something like Altomile, however Altomile would be during strike, but this one is during when this unit is placed on vanguard. So it's pretty awesome as well. So that will be the grid trees. Alright, so grid 2s. 3, Knight of Fragment. Yeah, so G break, generation break 1, when this unit attacks, a vanguard and you have 2 or more grid 2 and above rear guards. Wait, what? When two or more grade 2 rear guards, it gets plus 2k power and a special skill. So basically when an attack hits, inflict 1 damage and soul charge 1. Yep. So yeah, 11k attackers. Next we have 4 12k attackers. Generation break 1, 12k attacker. Nothing much. So basically this deck focus on calling and calling and calling. Right. Yep. So this is the key card as well. Generation break 1, counter blast 1. When this unit is boosted and it attacks, you can search your deck for a grid 2 card other than itself and call it to a rear guard circle. So calling itself would be too broken. So yeah, so basically 11k attackers and 12k attackers can hit the vanguard easily. So I will show you the killer combo of this deck after going through every card. Okay, grid 1s, 2 copies of 10k booster, helps of your vanguard 10k booster with G break 1. Yep, helps your vanguard hits magic numbers against 11k's. And 4 of this card, Knight of Something Circles. Yep, so basically when this unit is placed on rear guard, you can discard grade 3. You can reveal a grade 3 from your hand and search your deck for Altomile. And discard card from your hand. Yeah. So basically you can improve your consistency by searching for boss monsters. And it also helps pay the cost of strike. So when you strike, when this unit is used to pay cost for strike, its grade gets increased by 2. So essentially a grade 3. So you only have to discard one of these cards. Yep. And it's a 7k base. Pretty good. So next, 4 copies of Gigantech Shot Putter. So Counterblast 1, G-Break 1. Retire this unit, choose 2 units and plus 5k to them. So it's a 7k exchange for 5k. Very good as well. For 10k, sorry. And 4 Perfect Guards. So the Trollic Perfect Guards can protect rear guards as well. So when you have left with like one rear guard, you have to use this. So and basically I don't think really the unflip is much, so yeah, it's kinda not that great as well. So you can just use any perfect guard you like, personal preference. Trigger lineup, rainbow triggers, 4 crits, 4 stands. Okay, so stand trigger is special. So G-Break 1, when this unit is placed on rear guard, choose 2 units and give them plus 3k. And at the end of the turn, if you gave plus 3k, you have to return this to your deck. So you can return triggers. Yeah, 4 draws, 4 heals. So basically what's good about this deck, and why I run rainbow triggers, is because of Altomau's skill. So Altomau, okay, I'll set up. So let's say your field is here. So Altomau will be your key card. Hold on. Yep, so its skill grants your front row plus 5k. So if you get a stand trigger, you can stand your unit. Yeah, and it still has the plus 5k, so you make full use of it. So the... oh yeah, the G-Zone. Okay, I'll go through the G-Zone now. Okay, so 4 copies of Divine Sacred Dragon, Saint Blow Dragon. So its skill is like Persona Flip. So you flip up one of these copies from the G-Zone. Yeah, so your G-Zone, you flip it face up. Pay the cost for its effect. So it gets 3k for every rear guard, and if you have two or more face up cards in the G zone and you have two or more rear guards, it gets 1 crit. So it's essentially 15k and 1 crit if it has full fill. Pretty good. So that's the finisher, and this is the early game strike unit. So when this unit attack hits, search your deck for a grade 2 and above unit and call it to a rear guard. So basically that's it. Alright, I'll go on to the killer combo. So you have your Altomau. So this deck, you can basically same blow, which is the sort of finisher. You don't have to use it to finish your opponents off. You can use it to push your opponents to high damage count. And Altomau's a pretty good Altomau and the combos with the rear guards are pretty good for finishing off. So let's say you have this. Okay. And you have some random boosters. Sorry. Wait a moment. 10k, 7k, 7k. Okay. So here will be net. Hold up the camera for a bit. Okay, so basically, that would just let you see, have a clearer look at the field. Okay, so Twin Sword will hit. So you will swing with your rear guard for 17k. And then, okay, gotta do this quick. Device running out of memory pretty soon. Actually, just ran out and I just cleared some shit. Okay, so 17k, no boost, so it's very good. And you can hit with your Twin Sword, Counterblast 1, Superior Core, grade 2 unit other than Twin Sword, so you can call the same thing over. Because the keywords doesn't include open rear guard circle, so you can call over a rear guard and retire it. Yep, so you basically that's the first attack will be the first time the 12k attacker hit. Second attack from Twin Sword. Okay, third attack. And fourth attack from a Vanguard. And all of them will be strong attacks. And if you pull a stand trigger or something, stand this and you attack again. So yeah, make full use of the powers. So actually Garblade upside down. So actually Garblade will be quite a strong finisher as well. So if you strike above your Altomar, okay, you won't get the generation break power blast, power boost, however. So essentially if you do not, sorry, I should have compacted it. So if you do not boost, you just hit 12k and use your Vanguard and hit. And Vanguard skill, if the attack hits, you can superior call one unit. So second attack, third, superior call Twin Sword. Wait, I did this wrong. Hold on. Okay, so first attack, Vanguard. First attack, 12k. Second attack, superior call one unit. 12k, hit stick as well. Yep, attack again. Third attack, Vanguard attacks. Fourth, and superior call Knight of Twin Swords. No boost here. And boost it and attack. And you can superior call one more time here. So it's a 6 attack combo, so it's pretty strong actually. Granted that your Vanguard actually hits, that is. So right now Royal Paladins are very very strong against like Gear Chronicle. So there are clans that are mechanically not as good against other clans, like Kakeru isn't good against Grand Blue because it focuses on retiring, and Grand Blue gains effect from the units being in the drop zone. Yeah. So Gear Chronicle returns unit to the deck. However, as Royal Paladins, you can call them from the deck again. Yeah, so it's never ending cycle. So actually Gear Chronicle doesn't do anything much. Except for Chronos Command Dragon being scary, returning every single rare card. Yep, so that would be the end of the deck profile of my Royal Paladin Strike deck. Royal Paladin Strike deck featuring Altomar. Yep, so if you enjoyed this video, leave a like down below to show me some support, and if you like to see more, subscribe to my channel for new awesome deck profiles and product reviews and stuff like that. So with that, that will be the end of the deck profile. So bye guys!